Welcome to my poster for the EPS conference. I will be presenting some of the work I have been doing throughout my PhD at the University of York. We have been interested in testing the predictions of the procedural deficit hypothesis, which has proposed that an impairment in the procedural memory system could lead to neurodevelopmental disorders such as dyslexia. However, the serial reaction time task, which is frequently used to measure procedural learning, has recently been shown to have poor stability, posing a serious obstacle to using the SRT task in individual differences research. In the setup experiments with adults, we investigated some of the factors that may affect the stability of the SRT task, as well as explore the associations between procedural learning, language, literacy, and attention. In all experiments, we used a probabilistic SRT task where participants were asked to respond as fast as possible to the position of the stimuli on screen by pressing the corresponding key in a keyboard. Unknown to the participants, this task has two sets of trials, probable trials that follow a sequence that represented 90% of trials, and improbable trials that follow a different sequence and represent only 10% of the trials. The difference between response times for probable and improbable trials is taken to reflect procedural learning, as participants should become faster at responding to probable trials if they have learned the sequence. Adult participants were used in all experiments with more detail on the sample characteristics on the poster. Across experiments, there was a consistent procedural learning effect with response times being faster for probable and improbable trials. The within-session reliability, also referred to as split half reliability, was also good across experiments. However, the same cannot be said for the across-session reliability, also referred to as stability, which was always below the desired threshold of 0.70. Study 1 showed that stability remained low regardless of sequence similarity between the two sessions. However, study 2 and 3 were revealing on factors that affect stability. Study 2 revealed that stability increases with the number of sessions that participants complete, while study 3 showed that a task design feature, namely the interstimulus interval, also affects stability. Using an interstimulus interval between trials led to lower stability than having no interstimulus interval. In summary, we observed that the SRT task has suboptimal psychometric properties despite a consistent, highly replicable procedural learning effect. And despite good within-session reliability, the task is prone to poor across-session stability. Promisingly, as shown in study 2 and 3, there may be ways to improve the stability of this task, although note that these modifications still produce suboptimal levels of stability. Thank you for listening, and feel free to ask any questions in the Q&A session.